It's time for us to invite our next speaker for the day, speaking on skills to impress. He's the head of consulting and lead trainer at 3W Consulting, specializing in enterprise renewal, strategic change management, and high performance development in leadership, communication, as well as service. Throughout his career, he has been involved with startup companies and has worked towards implementing business processes. Among others, he is the only Sri Lankan to achieve the dual championship of evaluations and impromptu speaking 2016 for District 82 of Toastmasters International. Please give it up for Sandun Fernando.
I know why I am here. If you know why you are here, raise your hand. I'll repeat the question. I know why I am here. If you know why you are here, raise your hand. දැනගෙන ගියොත් කතරගම. නොදැන ගියොත් අතරමඟ. දන්නේ නැත්තම් මෙතනට අලහාරන්න දෙවිලා තියෙන්නේ. Before that, please give a round of applause to my trainer as well when I started work and a good friend, Sampath Trimavithana, for sharing those lovely tips. Please, round of applause. Thank you. And it is also the Asian culture and mine personally to appreciate and acknowledge people who have helped you along the way. Now, let me ask this question. There's a few of you who raised their hand and the rest of you didn't. I want to ask from the guys who raised their hand, why are you here, sir?
I want to build like a network and actually learn about interpersonal relationships as much as I know, little bit further, you know. Yeah.
Thank you. Let's give him a round of applause, please. Get used to it. Keep your lunch packet and the Milo and the books and everything down, because in this session you're going to do a lot of clapping, right? I saw some of the other hands going up somewhere here as well. Do you know why you're here, Puta? Dannawada. Single ingare kamanna kiyanne. Why are you here?
I came to listen to you.
දෙන්න තව කෑම් පැකට් එක අත්පුඩි යන්නේ මේ කෑම් පැකට් එක මට අහන්න ආව වගේ මගේ අර දෙවෙනි එක රයිට් thank you but jokes apart
I really want to know about how startups work and I'm really new to this subject that's why
thank you very much let's give him a round of applause as well ladies girl power female power there's a lot of you know not testosterone estrogen Right, ladies, anybody would like to respond? Madam, do you know why you're here? Okay, would you like to?
So we are selected to the competition and we want to like to create our product, to we need to improve our skills. So that's why we are here to learn.
Round of applause. Right, thank you very much. Now, like I said, I know why I am here, because number one, because I was invited, otherwise it'll be very awkward if I come here. Number two, why I said yes is because I believe if the country has to grow, if we are to move out of this current, not only economic, geopolitical, social conditions that we're in, we need to grow the economy, and a country like ours, the economy cannot grow unless people start thinking entrepreneur level and entrepreneur at small and medium level. We do not want another Facebook from Sri Lanka. We do not want another Oracle from Sri Lanka. But we want easily another 100,000 good small and medium startups. I believe in that. And also, I believe in what Nelson Mandela said long time ago, that if you want to save a nation, give them education. Right? Repeat that, please. Okay, I will say it slowly. Please repeat after me. If you want to save a nation, give them education. Yes, and that is my profession as well. I'm a trainer and I'm a speaker, and I would love to share what I have known, what I have learned from people who have come before me. with people so that it empowers you to go ahead and do something better. We can stay in the dark and blame the dark, or we can do a little we can to light a candle. And this country, needless to say, this is not a politically motivated speech, but needless to say, we are not in a very stable position, and the direction that we are going is also not very positive. If that is the case, one way of taking us out is we need to empower people, not only through startups, but through thinking as well, right? I think a idea එක තියෙන නිසා තමයි මම මේ වගේ දවසක මේ වගේ හවසට ඇවිල්ලා ඕගොල්ලොත් එක්ක මේ idea එක බෙදාගන්නේ. I have a son who is 1 year 11 months. I haven't seen him for 6 days because I was out of the country. I came late last night and I couldn't see him. So today after work, I should have been happily with him. But even for him to have a good country, people before him need to take the responsibility and do that. So I'm willing to sacrifice another couple of hours with him to be here with you because I believe in you. Let me repeat. I believe in you. In the potential that you have, in the capacity that you have to define not only your course of life, but that for many others, right? So whatever I'm going to share today, I don't know who out of this lot will win or lose, but whatever I'm sharing today, I hope you will take it with you and do something great with your life. And that for me is a much bigger achievement than winning this competition. Although winning this competition is good, my objective is to ensure that you build something, some skills for your life that you are going to go on and do better. Right? So I'm going to share some tips that are going to be useful because usually if I'm working with even a very senior, seasoned corporate executive who's delivering a one-hour presentation, I spend minimum 15 hours with that person. Right? So in 1 hour, with close to about 75, 80 of you, I won't promise I can do much. But knowing all of you, I understand y'all are here to absorb the knowledge, right? So because of that, get ready, get set, right? So I believe that is the purpose you are here. Methan ta avilla inne yam kisi deyak pilibandama danuman laba ganna. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes.
Right? Interaction is very important for us to go on because we've got, I'll keep it at about 45 minutes at the most. We promised to finish it at 8:30 latest. Let's try and get it done, right? All of us need to go home. So, if some of you are here because you don't know why you are here, at least now you know what you are getting. Is that good enough? Yes? Nattan kamekata vithara dawe. Da eka dunna. Is that good enough? I thought the sandwich was really nice, right? The chicken and the thing was very creamy. Yes? Right, okay. Nikan kandattam vela katha karannit naha ne. Right. Okay. So let me start from that point. I think Ms. Chandi Ramaratna used a valid point. She probably didn't drill it a little harder. Sampath, being the experienced trainer he is, he knew how to get it out. But let me tell you, I'm not going to work too hard to get it out, but I'm going to tell you what will happen if you don't. You could be in this forum. You could be 1 out of 80. But the speaker is asking, or the person who's delivering is asking you to respond with something. Can you give me a valid reason why you don't respond? Me wage forum ekaka wenna puluwang, meeta wada adu forum ekka wenna puluwang. Kenek tamanta katha kerula, mona hari deyak pilibandawa praticharayak illuwathin, e praticharaya nodenna salakiya yutu. Vedagat piliturak denna mata. Give me one good reason why you should not respond when somebody speaks to you.
Fear.
Fear. Fear of what, sir? Okay. 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 Right. So let's take it a step down because I'm here to talk about interpersonal skills, and for me, personally, this is one of the weaker skills. Imagine you're in the middle of 80 people. You're going to pitch a panel with your group of 4 or 5 people and you're going to have few people asking you questions. If you don't respond, everything else that you have done is down the drain. So let's get that sorted first. One reason is fear. Fear of what if I ask? Because you don't know what you might say or you don't know what the other person says. I will address that. Mang ekata pilithurak denna. Any other reason? Communication skills. Okay. Right. 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 Okay. Agree. Two valid reasons. Please give this gentleman a round of applause before he answers the third one. Also, someone else say. Give me one good reason. These are two valid reasons, I acknowledge. They're afraid what others might think. Good enough. Close to fear. So fear and communication. Two skills that you're talking about. What else? No idea. Okay. Fear, communication, no idea. What else? You're in a crowd of 80. Somebody is asking something from you. You are not responding. Give me a good enough reason. There are three reasons that I have acknowledged. Accept or not accept? Let's see. I have acknowledged. There are responses. Why? ඇයි මේ වගේ අවස්ථාවකදී කතා කරන්නේ නැත්තේ කවුරු හරි අහුවොතින් මොකටද ආවේ? කෑම එක කෑවද? ඒකට කැමතිද? ඔව්ද නැද්ද කියලා කියන්නේ නැත්තේ ඇයි? ඒකත් දන්නේ නැද්ද? IEEE වෙන සෙට් එකක් හොයාගන්න වෙනවා. මේ සෙට් එකේ මුකුත් මං හිතන්නේ වැදගත්මක් තියෙන දෙයක් ඇයි කියලා මෙම්ම. ආවේ ඇයි කියලාත් දන්නේ නැහැලු. කතා කරන්නේ නැත්තේත් ඇයි කියලා දන්නේ නැහැලු. අර කිව්ව අදහස් වලින් එකක් නම් ඔළුව හොල්ලන්න එක්ක ඕගලන්ට ඒක තේරෙනවා නะ. ඒ කියපු තුනෙන් එකක් කියලා Tamanට තියෙන ප්‍රශ්නේ මෙහෙම ඔළුව හොල්ලන්න. Fear, communication, no idea. ඔළුවත් හොල්ලන්න බැරිද? එහෙනම් නාය කසන්න මෙහෙම කළා. Tamang then respond karanne natte me reasons tunen ekak kiyala hitenawa nan nayakasan tak gala eka gehanu lamekte e thuna hari anith aya pute eka dannit nadda dai ehenam kanda dunne parak wenna kalin bus ekena yanna tak gala guys honestly I'll tell you it's disrespectful it is disrespectful I'll tackle one by one what you say Somebody asks you something. There is an answer. Right or wrong? There is an answer. And if you don't express that answer, there is no valid reason or a reason that you can understand and tell you this is why you didn't. Fear, let's take it. Fear comes from not knowing the answer. And like I said, there is an answer. Either you know it or you don't know it. There is a third category that your opinion, which the other person might think as correct or not. Either way, there is an answer. මොනම හේතුකට පිළිතුරක් තියෙනවා. මේක මම දන්නවද? ඔව්. මේක මම දන්නේ නැද්ද? නැහැ. මේක පිළිබඳව මට වෙන අදහසක් තියෙනවද ඒක? One of the three. You should be able to express that. When you don't express that and you have this blank face looking at people, it is absolutely offensive. Why do you think Ms. Chandiratna Dharmaratna went on a tangent to start talking about that? You are here. She's dedicating her personal time to come here and address you. And you are acting disrespectful. And if you think you're one of the 80, how you do something is how you do anything. මෙතනදි කතා කරන්න නැතුව හිඳලා හිතන්න එපා ඔයා ගිහිල්ලා කැපිටල් වෙන්චර් කැපිටලිස්ට් කෙනෙක්ට හරි ඉන්වෙස්ටර් කෙනෙක්ට හරි පිච් කරද්දි කතා කරේ කියලා. It doesn't work that way. Your mindset has to understand situations are the same. And I felt sorry for her as a speaker and as a trainer that she had to stand in front of some of you and then ask, I'm not going to move until you give an answer. How many of you here are from a foreign university? Except one gentleman. I probably have spoken, except for Rajarata and North and South, I have spoken in all these universities for the past 4 to 5 years, and one of the challenges that I get from people, it's on this subject, on interpersonal skills, getting ready for the corporate world. One of the challenges children give, I call them children because I'm still young and they are still children, right? Is that they believe the corporate world has this bias or the filter saying if you're from a foreign university, you get a chance. If you're from a local university, you don't. No, that's not true. Even Chandi mentioned that, Sampad mentioned, we have some of the smartest kids in the generation. But why is it that the local universities or children who have not got that foreign exposure, why do they not get that chance? Because of this simple skill of interpersonal skills. You have brilliant ideas, you just cannot go in front of people and pitch it. And one reason for that is this particular behavior. You don't speak up. Katha karanne. Dannawa nan dannawa kiyanda, danne naththam danne naha kiyanda. Mage idea ekak meka nan mage idea ekak meka kiyanda. Oye thunen ekak kiyanda. Oye thunen ekakwat kiyanne naththam, do not expect the other person to respect you. Because ask yourself, there is no other valid reason why you should not respond. කතා කරන්න පුළුවන් නම් අදහස මේ තුනෙන් එකක් නම් මේක කියන්නේ නැති වෙන කිසිම හේතුවක් නැහැ. You are telling me about communication. Fine, I give it to you. Sometimes it's a little intimidating when someone is speaking to you in English or a foreign language and you don't know it, you have the resistance. I will tell you about a boy I hired to do a sales job, and I'm very happy to say that he is now doing a fantastic job, probably earning more than me. When I did the interview 7 years ago for the very first time at the company that I was working at that time, I was conducting the interview and I asked him questions, couple of questions in English. He had a file, typical setup, file in his hand, and he came for the interview. When I looked at his shoes, I could say that he has not polished it or he has walked a long distance, right? The tie definitely didn't look like a tie that he was wearing. So from the very beginning, he didn't have the tick box answers to get through the interview. And when I asked him a first couple of questions, he didn't answer. He was struggling. And then he said the most amazing thing that I have heard in my short span of 15 years of working. He looked at me and he said, "Sir, ahana prashna mata therena. English in uttara denna pa single in uttara denna." I just fell in love with that boy that very moment, and I said, "Man singhalen prashne handa." And I hired the guy. That guy recorded the most, the best performance, the sales and everything. Because what did he have? He had the courage and the authenticity to say, "I don't know English. Your job doesn't want English. Let me tell you what I can in my language." So singhalen katha karanna puluwan nan ingreesiyen katha karanna beri kiyala kisima prashnayak naha. I can understand if you're meeting foreign investors who don't speak Sinhalese. Even if that is the case, they will have a translator there. Because a smart foreign investor will never come to Sri Lanka without having any understanding of Sinhala and a Sinhala support. So either way, whatever the language that you know, you can speak it. You need to embrace that confidence and then start it. Meka hithara ganna. Metana kee denek Indiyave inna pudgalayak ekka ingreesiyen katha karala thiyenada? Atha ussan. කොච්චරක් අපි ඒගොල්ලන්ගේ ඇක්සෙන්ට් එකට විහිළුක කරනවාද චපාති what are you talking yaar yaar එක බවුන්ස් කරලා දෙන්නේ right ඒක ගැන අපි hina වෙනවා but you look at the top tech giants in this country Satya Nadal CEO of Microsoft Sundar Pichai CEO of Google Indra Nooyi chairman of Pepsi Corporation. And very recently, I heard that there was another Indian lady who got into one of these big boards and everything. If you listen to them, they don't. I was just in India for the last 6 days, learning how they do it. They don't care. English is the English language. They don't care. They have made it their own. And the beauty of it is, just like the Chinese would speak to you in Chinese and expect you to understand Chinese when you look like this, they are Indians looking at foreigners and speaking English their way, expecting the foreigner to understand it and then respond. Ladies, excuse me using this word, gentlemen, that is what is called having balls. Right? Tamanta jeevithe idiriyata giilla yam kisi deyak laba ganna on nan puthe duwe amma taattat kiyalana deepu nathi deyak thamai katha karanna purudu wenna. And Kataka Raddi, say what you have to say. Your silence, this dumbstruck look, doesn't respond to anything. You know it, say you know it. You don't know it, say you don't know it. You have a different idea, say this is my idea. Pitch it and then see. I know everybody is talking about technology, artificial intelligence and everything, but the one machine that has still not been found is the machine to figure out your thoughts. Eka una ekamatana PK කියන අර movie එක විතරයි. මතකනේ ඇමරිකාන ඇඳුන් නැතුව රේඩියෝ එකක් තියාගෙන හිටිය movie එක මතකයිද? PK. සම්පත් එහෙම බලලා ඇති film. PK ට තිබුණනේ talent එකක් අද්ද ගල්ලලා ඉවරලා හිතේ තියෙන දේ කියන්නේ. ඒ මැෂින් එක ඇත්තට නැහැ. ඒ ability එක කාටවත් නැහැ. So the first thing you need to learn without before going into any depth is when somebody speaks to you, it is the most respectable thing to do to respect and respond. Even if you don't know, just say, I don't know. If you don't do that, the only idea that I get is you think you're too cool or you're too good for the person who's talking to you. And if you think you're too cool and too good for me, what makes you think that I'll be happy to part my money with you? I understand this is a bit uncomfortable. But I'm not here to make you comfortable. I'm here to tell you and share with you knowledge and ideas that is useful for you to build something for yourself. 4 weeks ago, I was with one of my clients, a large travel company. When I say large, because they do top line above 700 million plus. It's a relatively big travel company. And this boss, the managing director, who's my client, I was working with them to implement two systems. Brought in about 12 to 14 of his senior team, starting with two COOs and the senior management team. And this managing director was asking a few questions. I was saying a few things and I was asking them, did you understand? Yes, guys, yes. I have been working with this set for some time. So I know them. Man, did you guys get it? That managing director was paying attention for some time and he told me to wait and he said this in Sinhalese. Last senator, shirt andala, tie okkoma andala, hitiya managers la set ekak maath ehema hiti ingreesiyen katha karagena yana wedagat meeting ekak maddde MD ko honda balla kiwwe me gon 70ta man gewanne mekatada. True story. And I also was a little bummed. I looked at him and I was like, MD, sorry, what? Man hita ehema kiyaddi matat ekka eka kiwwe kiyala. But what he said is, you are asking them questions, I am asking them questions, they don't have the courtesy to respond. Am I paying these idiots for doing this? And I know three people in that lot got warning letters. Because immediately after that, the rest of the 9 or 10 people said, yes, MD, no MD. Tundane ketana katha karenne, very next day, three of them, very senior managers, their bonuses are above 6 figures, 7 figures in fact, above 1 million rupees. Three of them the very next day got warning letters and said, if you continue this behavior, you will have to find a new job. I spent 15 minutes putting a lot of fear into you because I want you to understand this is one of the most disappointing and disturbing skills that we have. And let me share with you something else. Do you know why we have that? Do you like to know why we have this behavior? Yes or no? Tamat yes kiyanne nathi ung innada metara. Do you like to know why we have this behavior? Yes or no?
Yes.
Culturally, we are conditioned like that. When we go to school, if we start speaking, teacher tells you to shut up. Wediya katha karanne paamu. Guru deguru hamu edi parents teacher meeting ekedi amma taatta aapam teacher mokadda kiyanne mu kanthi katha karana wedi. Gedaredi katha karala kaya gahuwa taatta amma mokadda kiyanne ei kata hagen hitwa. True or false? Culturally, we have been conditioned to keep quiet. Kyan dena de kala vena de balagen inda. We have been trained to do that. And here, people come and talk about, come, let's go conquer the world, let's take over. How are we going to do that when we have suffocated our own voices? So please, even if you don't take anything that I say from this point for the next 20 minutes, remember this. Even if you are in a forum of 1 or 1,000, when somebody speaks to you and requests for a response, please respond. It is courtesy, it is respect, and if there is 1,000 people and you are the only one who's responding, for the rest of them, you might be a muttiya, gotta and all of that. But for the one person who's asking the question, you are the person they want to work with. Is that clear? Yes. Is that clear?
Yes.
Hereafter, please, in any forum, do not behave that way. It's disrespectful. And it is not good interpersonal skills. Although I am one here and I'm talking to all 80 of you at once, I am speaking to all 80 of you at once. So when I'm asking, did you understand, even if one person says no, I will stop and explain. Because it's important. Right? But if none of you respond, I wouldn't know whether you understood or you didn't understand. So the productivity of this communication and this conversation is zero. So please, start with that. And muster enough courage to say, yes, no, I don't know, or this is my opinion. Muster enough courage to say, ඉංග්‍රීසියෙන් කියන්න බැරි නම් සිංහලෙන් කියන්නම් මට තේරුනේ මේකයි මේකයි මගේ අදහස. And remember this very importantly. If somebody judge you today saying that you can't speak in English and they try to not do business with you, you're better off not doing business with that person. If somebody cannot give you the benefit right now thinking you are not speaking English or your language is wrong or your grammar is wrong and everything, you're better off not working with that person right now. The flip side of that, මේ කතාවේ අනිත් එක තමයි, තමන් ඉංග්‍රීසි කතා කරන්නේ නැත්නම් තමන්ට ඉංග්‍රීසි, තමන් ඉංග්‍රීසි කතා බහ ගැන යම්කිසි හීනමානයක් තියෙනවා නම් මොන කෙහෙල් මලකටද බලන් ඉන්නේ? You all are all smart individuals who have gone on to study complex things like mathematics, combined mathematics and engineering, as I understand, electronic, electrical, all of that. You have studied business. Balance sheet tab balance karna kiyanne mona tarang aul deyakda. You have studied all of that and you are telling me you can't put in a bit of effort to learn English. Why? Who are you going to give these excuses to? Then when you get the opportunity, you blame the foreign universities. Vijatiya kumantrana. ඒක තමයි මේ ලොකු කම්පනීස් ඔක්කොම පිටරටවල් වලින් එන උන්ට රස්සාවල් දෙන්නේ. Not that we don't have anything. I do believe as well that we have some of the smartest kids coming out of our university system. But let me explain this to you. If I am a company that is dealing with foreign clients, and if I am not there and I'm going to recruit you to go and sell that to the foreign client, I want that personality. I want that communication skills. I want that confidence. මං ඔයාට පඩියක් දීලා ඔයාව අරගෙන ඔයාව පුරුදු කරන්න මට බෑනේ. I am managing a running business. So when I hire you for some of the skills that you have. And communication is one. So on that day, don't tell අර පිටරට ගිහිල්ලා ඉගෙනගෙන ආපු මේ ළමයාට chance එකක් දෙනවා ලංකාවේ අපිට chance එකක් දෙන්නේ නැහැ. No, I am running a business. Even if that guy has half of your intelligence and your brains, I'm going to recruit that idiot because he knows to put a show in front of my client and get me the business. And at the end of the day, that is what I want. So if you know this reality, please raise your hand if today is the first day you're hearing about the importance of English. අද දවසේ ජීවිතේ පළවෙනි වතාවට ඉංග්‍රීසි වල වැදගත්කම තේරුම් ගන්නවා නම් අත උස්සන්න. නෑ. ඔබතුමිය විතරයි. You have not understood. Okay, there is one. The rest of you knows the importance of English. And honestly, raise your hand if you have less confidence about your English communication. I promise I'm not going to ask any questions. Tamang ingreesi katha baha pilibandawa tikak adu aathmavishwasayak thiyena nam atha ussanna hondata. Hondata atha ussanna. Right. Most of us have it. So my request is, work on that. Because I do agree with you, what you suggested. One reason why a lot of you don't respond is because you're scared of the language. You're scared that if you give one answer, then you will be asked another question. එකක් කියලා නා ගන්නවට වඩා කටවහගෙන ඉන්න එක හොඳයි. ඒකනේ අපි හිතන්නේ. But I'm telling you, if you cultivate these attitudes, we can't make it big. We can't go forward. And then we will go back to what our fathers and their fathers did. We will start blaming. දැන් තමයි හොඳම වැඩේ හා මේකේ කොහෙන් හරි වෛරයක් ගැලවිච්ච ගාම්ම රයිට් කතා කර කර හිටියත් අමතකුණානේ කොතනද මං හිටියේ ඉම්පෝර්ටන්ස් ඔෆ් ඉංග්ලිෂ් රයිට් සෝ නවු දැට් යු නෝ ඉට් ප්ලීස් ඉන්වෙස්ට් සම් ටයිම් ඇන් ඩිවෙලප් යෝර් කමියුනිකේෂන් ස්කිල්ස් ඉෆ් යු වොන්ට් ටු බී සක්සෙස්ෆුල් ඇස් ඇන් ඔන්ටර්ප්‍රනර් යු නීඩ් ටු ඉන්වෙස්ට් on your communication skills. Is that all right? How many of you know about Jack Ma? Raise your hand. Right, Jack Ma is the richest man probably in China. He is the founder and the president of Alibaba Group, right? Do you know that Jack Ma used to, well, he's born to a very poor traditional Chinese family and he's right now in his 50s, if I'm not mistaken, which means he was living in China, the socialist China, for most of his life, where there is no English. You're talking about 70s and 80s. Raise your hand if you know of Jack Ma's story. Okay, there's a few of you. Very good. For the benefit of the ones who don't know, he used to cycle every day for 40 minutes to come to the town because he lived 40 minutes away from town. During his school years, he used to come to the town because there was a tourist hotel. And there used to be foreigners who came to China. He used to offer them free city tours simply because he could talk to them in English. And he did this for years. And he understood, he learned English. Because why? He believed in the future that one day China is going to open. And when China opens up, the communication language, the link language globally is English. And if he taught himself to speak English, he's going to be ahead of a lot. And he applied the same thinking into IT as well. Early 90s, he went into the United States. How many times did he apply to go into a United States business school? He has applied more than 10 times to Harvard. He was rejected. And now Harvard has to get appointments to invite him to come and speak at their school. Right? But the point that I'm trying to drive is he rode a bicycle 40 minutes every day just so he could speak to a few foreigners. I was in Thailand last October and I booked an Uber because I wanted to travel. I was with my family. You'd be surprised. The Uber that came was a Toyota Fortuner Jeep. I was like, interesting. And once I got into the vehicle, the driver, I'm not exaggerating this, the driver was wearing a Rolex watch. And this, I like watches, I saw this and I got me talking and I asked the guy, you have a very good vehicle and you seem like a pretty decent chap who's making money. What makes you drive Uber? He laughed and he said, he's an engineer. He's an engineer based in Thailand. He's working for a local company, he's quite successful. However, his English is not good. So he drives his Jeep on weekends as an Uber driver because he gets to talk to foreigners while they drive. And he's doing that. Now, if Jack Ma, who's right now the richest man in China, did that, if there is an engineer in Thailand who's driving Uber because he wants to talk to, what is your excuse of not developing your communication skills? Do you want to wait for next 3 years, go back home one day and cry to your parents or to your husband or wife or spouse telling that I didn't get that capital that I was looking for because my pitch wasn't good enough or because I didn't speak enough language? Do you want to wait for another 3 years and regret or do you want to take some action today? Decide for yourself. Because to speak English in a way that you can do business, you only need to know 800 to 1,000 words. And I guarantee if you have to sit down now and start writing all the words that you know, you will know a minimum of 300 to 400 words. And if you start learning two words a week, you will learn approximately 100 to 110 words a year. With the 300 that you know, you add another 100. In the next 2 years, you can start speaking English. All what you need to do is improve the grammar terms. And there are only 21 grammar rules that you need to understand. And you can speak any language, if you know those 21 grammar rules. Now, I'm going to ask a question. Give me an excuse as to why you shouldn't start speaking good English in the next 1 year. 2 words a week. Start speaking to somebody. Because a lot of the interpersonal skills come down to confidence. And confidence, like you all rightly said, comes down to the fact of fear and lack of communication skills. If you can take these two and develop it, the rest of it flows through. So please, my dear friends, take this one message before I go into the other tips and take it to your heart. Improve your communication skills. Invest your time and your money on that. If you have a group of friends of 3 or 4, come together and pay to a decent tuition master. Get a tuition class. Don't go to something like Sakwidi. But then I heard that he's a good English teacher. So if you want to go, still go. But find yourself a good English tuition master if you don't want to go to a math class. Dedicate 2 hours a week. Get yourself a tuition instructor coming in. O-level, A-level karanda class gheela nathi ekkenek methana thussan. O-level, A-level walata kavadavat ekak class ekkatawat giye ne. Then there's no excuse, no? You understand the value of getting extra help. So fix your language first. Because I'll tell you why. When the venture capitalists or the investors are seated in a forum and they're willing to pitch the idea, before you walk in, your confidence is communicated through your body language and the way you approach. And this confidence comes from what you think. That is the start of these interpersonal skills. And one of the main factors of this confidence is your conviction, your ability in your communication. Oyata oyage communication oyage language ekak gana confident nathnam me room ekata ævilla investors ata pitch karanna oya enne 50% confidence ekakin eka athulata eddi ævidina vidiyen eye contact karana vidiyen balana vidiyen etana inna kattiyata therenawa e inna kena etakota balanne mage issrahata ævilla idea ekak katha karaganna beri me pudgalayata mage salli dala kohomada man business ekak karanne because understand this. These are people who are listening to a minimum of 20 to 25 pitches every month. And during the contest time, guaranteed they will hear a lot more. If that is the case, they're not going to go through the whole PwC, PVC and all these things Sampath said, because in the first 90 seconds, they are going to make up their mind whether they're interested or not. 90 seconds, that is why you were asked to pitch in the first 1 minute. I'm not making this up. This is science. In the first 90 minutes, people create an impression of people. First 90 seconds. And in that first 90 seconds, if you are not confident because language jaga gana shuwan naha kiyala, before you start the race, you have given yourself a disadvantage. Is that clear? So the most important thing, invest in your language, build that confidence, take away the fear of responding. If you know the answer, say yes and give the answer. If you don't know the answer, say, sorry, I don't know. Third, if you have a different opinion, say, this is my opinion. And you don't have to worry about what others think, but you don't have to worry about what others think. You only have to worry about what you need to say. And if you say what you have to say, that is important. Is that clear? Very good. So now I'm going to the next point. Now, here is an important thing about interpersonal skills, the first impression. And like I said, the first impression, there's a different school of thought. Some people say it's 90 seconds, some say it's 12 to 15 seconds. Either way, what is the first thing people notice when they see you? What's the first thing? Give me some ideas. Mokadda palaweni de people tawa kenek notice karanne oglanga dakkama. appearance, your physical appearance, face, facial expressions, and your physical appearance, right? So get this thing right. In business, there is a saying that goes, never judge a book by its cover. Not true. Don't go by that. Everybody judges a book by its covers, right? Especially when it comes to venture capitalists and investors, and they're willing to invest business. So please don't be misguided by this concept that Steve Jobs turtleneck ekai jeans and shoes daagane hitiye Mark Zuckerberg crew neck t-shirt ekak vitarai andagene inne mehema mehema kiyala. The day you become Mark Zuckerberg, dress like that. The day you become Steve Jobs, dress like that. Until then, dress up for the occasion. Understood? Repeat it after me. Dress up for the occasion. Everybody look at the partner. Everybody look at the partner. Look at the partner. Repeat this line. Nagita pang. Repeat. Come. Tell your partner. Hiyeng. Tell your partner. Ah, right. Now wake up. This last 10 minutes is what I'm going to share this information that is useful to you. So wake up for these 10 minutes and then pay attention. Number one, people judge you by the way you dress. So please don't be fooled by this crew neck, t-shirt, turtleneck culture. That shit doesn't work. This is not Silicon Valley. Right? So dress up for the occasion. This doesn't mean that you need to go and spend all your money in buying the most expensive brands. No, that's rubbish. You need to have clean, neat, fitting clothes. Clean, neat, fitting clothes. Right? Tamange angeta galapena andung andinda. Why do you think I came dressed in a tie? Why do you think Chandi was dressed in a sari, Sampath was dressed in a jacket? It's our training, it's our upbringing. You dress up to respect the party that you're meeting. Let me ask you a question here. Let's say you get an opportunity to meet Honorable Sirisena, President of the country. How will you go? Malle ovidiyata andagena? Yes or no? Ah. Why? Not because you have any regard for Honorable Sirisena, but you respect the office he represents, the President of the Democratic Socialist Republic of Sri Lanka. Out of that courtesy, you will go dressed up. Usaviyata gihilla indaka baanna me button saragena mehema karala katha karannako. Hey, lawyer, na lawyer ne mokak? Nadu waradama? Eh, waradi ne. Why do you not do that? Because that protocol demands it. When did we lose that at business? You dress up because you want to show that it matters. Ai ena rubber syrup e kota kalisan indagena wedding walata yanne natte. Ai එහෙම ගිය හිඟන්නන්වත් මන් දන්නවා එහෙම 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 යන්නේ නැත්තේ ඇයි because there is a dress code for an occasion that is honored and respected. Again, why do you not want to do that? So ladies and gentlemen, dress up, because when you dress good, you feel good. What is it? Repeat. When you dress good, you feel good. Repeat. When you you're dressed properly, you walk into the room, you don't feel intimidated. Because imagine, you go in some parna pair of jeans and rubber slippers and this thing, there will be 1% of crazy people who feel cocky and arrogant in that kit. I love that kit, don't get me wrong. You would see me wearing that 90% of the time. But when I have to do something in front of an audience, when I have to represent business, my company and myself, I will dress up because I respect you. So how you dress is not about how cool you are, it's about how respectful you are to the other person. So please invest in a decent shirt, some corporate slacks, nice belt, shoes for gentlemen, and a nice tie. If you want to wear a jacket, better. I was 24 years, I was working for a consultant from Accenture. One of the first things that he taught me was that I need to have a jacket and it should be hung in office every day. We don't know when we get to meet clients. Right? I like what Sampath said because that's one of the motives I had as well. Growing up watching all those Western movies, I thought that was good. And here's another thing. Godak ay kiyana kathawak ne me mewa tamai kiyanne videshiya kumanthrana kiyala. Godak ay kiyana me Lankawa kiyanne divaina. Divaina kinna minissu andinnone divaina kata galana wen. Enam palayan Hawaii walata. Right? You want to do business here, you dress up for business. I'm not saying you need a tie, but if you dress up in a tie, it's the perception. You're going there to pitch an idea. You need these people to be impressed by you. We dress for comfort. We dress for comfort. We are in an island, 31 degrees. In business, you don't dress for comfort. You dress for comfort when you are at home. You dress for comfort when you go for a movie. You dress for comfort when you are with your woman. No dress. Anyways, you dress for comfort in different contexts. When you are in business, you dress to impress. What is it? Repeat. Dress to? Repeat. Dress to? Get yourself a good pair of shirts, slacks and shoes and tie. Dress up. Even if it is the one thing that you're going to wash and wear it, wear it, please. It's important. When everybody's going to walk in with like crew necks and all this, kadicha richa shirt, teliyenda agana mehema, mehemai. Sarigama Productions walata gilla sinduwa denna yanawa nan ehema yanna. Naththam Green Path ekey indala art pikunana nan ehema enna. Museum ekata gilla mona hari e wage arts and crafts karana nan I think they accept it. I don't know. I have never been on the pitching side of a art business. එතකොට කොණ්ඩේ වවාගෙන ඉරිච්ච දේවල් ගාගෙන ගියා නම් සිරිබොරම තමයි. Right? But if you are coming to pitch and ask for money from a investor, from a venture capitalist, who by the way, most of the time is dressed up, will be either in a shirt and a tie or with a jacket or with a decent shirt and pants and things. If you walk in front of with them half dressed, they are going to intimidate you with their appearance. So you need to dress. And when you are dressed and you walk in there with a jacket, people look at you and they're like, there's something impressive about it. And here is the thing. After that, if you have a dumb idea, you're still dumb. But you at least get 2 minutes to present your dumb idea when you're dressed like that. Otherwise, even if you have the most brilliant answer, they start with a negative impression. They start thinking, මේ පුද්ගලයාට මේ මීටින් එකටවත් ලස්සනට පිළිවෙලට ඇඳලා ඉන්න බැරි නම් කොහොමද මෙයාව මම පාර්ට්නර් කෙනෙක් හැටියට අඳුන්වලා දෙන්නේ? Think about that. I'm not joking because we work with a lot of these capitalists and these investors. And they give us feedback. Some young kids come with brilliant ideas, right? Don't overdo the whole creativity part of it. And I have been at a pitch where I was pretty impressed how the team came in like a uniform. They were all wearing white shirts, black pants and a similar colored tie and everything. And when you have 4 or 5 people coming in like that to pitch an idea, when there has been 25 different pitchers and everybody is very average, this is one thing where you stand out. So ladies, I'm not going to give you fashion advice. Mama danne ogolo kohomada andinne kiyala, but get into a nice business suit or even a very nice sari. It doesn't matter what, but dress up for the occasion, because in business, you don't dress for comfort, you dress to impress. මටත් හරි අපහසුයි මේ ටයි එක දාගෙන ඉන්න හවස් වෙද්දී. ඒත් මොකද කරන්නේ? You need to show up for the game like you mean business. Right? So take that idea. And then the next thing is, have a very confident handshake and an introduction of yourself. Group එකකට ඇවිල්ලා කට්ටිය හිටියත් walk up to them one by one, shake hands and introduce yourself. Sinhalese or English, it doesn't matter. Mention your name. If you have a company name, mention that. Hi, I'm Sandun Fernando from 3W Consulting. Nice to meet you. Pleasure to meet you. Nice to meet you. You go there like you already own that business. When you are dressed nice, when you are confident with your language and your product and whatever the idea you want to pitch, the rest of it is mechanical. And that first impression is the most important part. So walk up. Have a firm handshake. And when you do the handshake, remember Sampath's dance? What did he learn out of dancing? Yeah, dancing gane kiyala kiyuwe mokadda aya igena gatte etani? Ekai ahagena indala inne. Anith aya mokada Jennifer Lopez diya balan hitiyane e welawama. Eke pennuwe Jennifer Lopez e muna vitarai monada hituwe? Lamai. Gyan lamai kawuda Richard Gere diya balan hitiye? Eya thought kiyala kiyala thiyena mage wife ut. Kamanne. Right. So coming down, eye contact and a firm handshake. Puta, end issarada. Now see, I'm going to do a handshake with him.
Hi. Me stance ke mistakes keep at kiya. මංගොබලන්ට ඒක කියලා දෙන්න. එකක් තමයි අශාන් මේ ඉන්න විදිය අශාන් පොඩ්ඩක් කොන්ෆිඩන්ස් කියන එක පේන්නේ නැහැ. එයා ටිකක් පැකිලා වගේ. රයිට්? අනිත් එක තමයි අත එයාගේ ඇඟටත් ළඟ වෙදී එයා අත මෙහෙම තියාගෙන ඉන්න නිසා එයාව මගේ වෙතට අදින්න තියෙන chance එක වැඩි. රයිට්? So here's a couple of things to remember. One thing is Asha, give yourself a little bit of distance. Put your right leg forward. You shake hand with your right hand, yes? So put your right leg forward so that it gives you a little bit of space. Tilt your body slightly so that your handshake is like this. Right? Go, done. Then may my ek enaga or heel enaga. Heel to one hai. So then basta bain oge like this. Have your confidence so that when you are one foot like this, you give your handshake. And if it is the first time you are meeting somebody, don't put the second hand. Don't put the second hand because this is only if you know this person and only if it is like Sampath said, it's a political power play. Otherwise, this is not necessary. This is a very firm business handshake. Put your right leg forward, lean a little forward, and your arm should be bent from here. Grip is here, thumb to thumb. This yoke is a grip and don't squeeze too hard. Gym ekata giyana kamanna eka medara bennan deba. Sometimes you meet people when you shake hands with them, atallama hi and sana. Don't do that. You're not showing your strength here, show your strength with your intelligence. And what you say is return the pressure. Anith ekkena allana level ekata mehema allanna. On that note, for Sri Lankan ladies, මහරජිනාගේ මෙහෙම කරන්න එපා. අත හරියට අල්ලන්නේ මෙහෙම අල්ලන්නේ. අම්මලා තාත්තලා දන්නා නොදන්න මිනිස්සුන්ගේ අත අල්ලන්න එපා කිව්වා තමයි. බිස්නස් වලට ගියාට පස්සේ ඒක අදාළ නැහැ. Even if you are a female, have a very confident handshake. Hold the hand, right? And how many pumps? සමහරු ඉන්නා නේද? කොහොමද කියන්නේ මොනරාගල පැත්තේ අර නල්ලි දක් ගන්නවා. Forward, you lean a little forward, take a firm grip, not too tight, just about tight, three pumps, I am sound. And let go. Allagi inne pa. Thunsarayak kalligala atharinne, right? එතකොට ඒක නත් ඉබේම අතාරිනවා නැත්තම් මෙන්න මෙතනින් පටන් ගන්නවා මම එකවස්ස එකක් because you know what happens after 3-4 pumps you are not willing to let go because you think other person will get upset. They are also thinking the same. Now by the way, both of you are holding it and now you don't know when to let go. After 3 pumps, let go. And boys, after 3 pumps, time allowing to do a lot. Subject sake. Anyways, ladies, gentlemen, everyone, go up, put your right leg forward, firm handshake, eyeball to eyeball contact and say hi. Nice. Right. Give Asha a round of applause.
Is that clear?
Yes. Please work on this. It's okay if you didn't know this until now. But now that you know it, practice. Make a natural yenne, boys and girls. We are not from a foreign country. We don't shake hands with people all the time. Right? So because of that, it's okay that we are not used to it. That is why you need to practice it now. Don't wait for that business opportunity to practice your handshake for the very first time. It's a stupid thing. Invest some time. Call a couple of your friends and do this. Remember, don't be shy, don't be embarrassed to learn. If you learn and you practice, you're better than yesterday. And that is all we can expect from you. And that is all you can do for yourself. Right? And here's the next thing. Handshake is very important when you come in confident and do that. So practice that if you don't get it. And practice that with an introduction of yourself. Have a very confident line where you say, good afternoon, good evening, I'm Sandun from Third Wave. Nice to meet you. Just mention that. And when the other person says, hi, I am Ashan from ABC Capital. Hi, Ashan. Nice to meet you. First time meeting ekak na. But if you have met them before, you don't need to introduce yourself again. You can say, hi Ashan, good to meet you. How are you? I understand the handshake is not a part of our culture. But again, guys, you got to play for the business culture. A handshake, unless it's culturally prohibited, because just over the last weekend, I tried to handshake with a lady, shake hands with a lady. She's from a different cultural background. She doesn't shake hands. So in that case, there's nothing wrong. I just said, oh, okay, sorry. That's it. And move on. But if you are, we are not from a culture where we don't shake hands. I would love to say Ayubowan, but we don't do that. And if you're somebody who wants to do that, all my respect, go ahead and do that. Either way, have a greeting. If you want to say Ayubowan, sometimes when I meet foreigners, I do that. And sometimes when foreigners come to Sri Lanka, they do that because it's showing cultural sensitivity. And when you have a foreigner saying Ayubowan to you, it's very impressive. So figure out on your greeting, practice that. And then when you go there, with all confidence in that first 10 to 12 seconds, give a nice introduction, lean forward and say, hi, Sandun, nice to meet you. And then the next thing about interpersonal skills is your body language and your eye contact. Whenever you are talking to people, remember these basics. Maintain eye contact at all times as much as possible, right? And if someone else is seated, it's okay if you sit or you're standing. But most importantly, if someone else is standing, do not be seated. Get up and talk to them. It doesn't matter whether they are senior to you or junior to you. It's respect and courtesy that if someone else is standing, you stand up and talk to them. Especially in a business context. Little things, but keep in mind. You might be seated, somebody comes, unless of course they tell you, sit or stand. And here's another thing. Sir, madam is no longer in use. However, first name is also not in use unless you get the permission. If you know somebody, say Mr., Miss., Fernando, Pereira, use the last name. That's the correct thing. Not the first name, but the last name or the second name. What's your name, madam? Minushi? Lakshika. So you can say Miss Lakshika. Right? What's your name, sir?
Arib Nista.
So Mr. Nista. Use that business language. It's very, very professional and it impresses people. But when I say Mr. Nista, if Arib says, call me Arib, then it's okay. Because a lot of these investors and capitalists, they will always tell you, hey, call me Sandun. It's okay. Unless and until they tell you that, don't try to walk in front of all these people and say, hey, Arib, how? Arib, puta adama. Right? Little things, learn. And also, here's another thing. Sometimes during the competition, you may get to interact with them in a very formal setup. So they will probably be seated, you come in, you make your presentation, that's it. But like what Sampath said, business deals, business networking doesn't happen only in boardrooms. There are in other places, right? Couple of you want to be excused, no problem, right? Business interactions happen in other places as well. So when in other places, when you meet somebody, if it is not immediately a business pitch, learn this thing. Practice a little bit of what is called small talk. Small talk is basically non-personal conversation about a few things. Not politics, not religion, not sex. Why? Because these are personal things. So don't go and go up to people that you haven't met, and just because you want to make friends, don't go up to them and first thing you say is, hey, UMP charter government, Sirisena, IEO Sirisena. Don't start conversations like that because you don't know their political alliance. So you might end up offending them. Or don't go up to them and say like, Arif Lane, Dendo. Don't say things like that because that is also discrimination, politically incorrect. You walk up to people and talk something impersonal like weather. Ah, it's a little cold today, isn't it? Oh, it's a little warm today, isn't it? Medasatika Vahina, neither. Yeah. Touch on something like business. Right? How's work for you these days? How's business these days? Things picking up. Things. Avoid negative conversations. Business kena katha karaddi kiyanne ba ayyo dollar ekak wetla ne ai chau chau patang ganna kalima armini adi thana mooth ekka weda karoth ma chau chau kiyala. Right, no problem. So practice 2-3 very simple conversations and topics. If there is something important like sports happening, just be up to date. You only need it for the first 30 seconds just to break the ice. Go mother. శ్రీలంకన్ టీమ్ నెట్బాల్ ఛాంపియన్షిప్ ఏదేలాని ఎక్కడికి అండి బా వాలీబాల్ ఛాంపియన్షిప్ దీని లైక్ ఇలా మినిస్టర్స్లో అత్తే వరద్దు కానీ ఏమో అలవెడగరగా అండి బా ఎక్కువ దన్న దగ్గర కథాగరండి నెత్తం కథాగరండి నిపా కానీ వ్యతిరేకతమై సేఫ్ నెత్తం వెన్ యూఆర్ టాకింగ్ టు సంబడీ యూ కెన్ ఇఫ్ యూఆర్ ఇన్ అ సెటప్ యూ కెన్ స్టార్ట్ సంథింగ్ ఇంపర్సనల్ లైక్ ఏ నైస్ ఆడిటోరియం రైట్ వర్చెస్ ఐ మీన్ ఐ రియలీ లైక్ దిస్ బ్యాక్ డ్రాప్ వాట్ యూ థింక్ ఇంపర్సనల్ యూ ఓన్లీ నీడ్ 2-3 లైన్స్ జస్ట్ టు స్టార్ట్ ద కాన్వర్సేషన్ బై ద వే దిస్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఐఎమ్ డూయింగ్ స్లోలీ గోయింగ్ టు దాట్ బట్ దట్ ఫస్ట్ ఫ్యూ సెకండ్స్ రిమెంబర్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ అ పిచ్ If it is a pitch, like what Sampath said, no nonsense. In the first 1 minute, you have to give the idea. But if it is networking at not a pitch level, you need to have one or two lines that you are going to use. So these are few things that you need. But I spent a bit of time driving this point that your confidence is what is important. And if you think your confidence is lacking because fear or language, don't wait another day to complain. Start working on yourself now. You'd rather put the work today, whether you win or lose and grow yourself, than wait for another 3 years to look back and regret thinking, shit, I should have studied. I'm not saying English is very important. I'm just saying it's a business language. It's a link language. When you know that, you get an advantage. And after that, dress to impress. You don't dress for comfort in business. You dress. Once you get to know them, if you're meeting on a regular basis, then you can come down. Some of my clients that I work with on a more regular basis, I don't go with the shirt and the tie. But I still don't wear a crew neck. I still don't wear a t-shirt. I would roll up my sleeves and go in a casual shirt. Because I believe in dressing up and it puts me at a comfortable situation. Right? So remember that. And then the next thing is, work on a firm handshake, practice that. And whenever you walk into a room, it doesn't matter who is there, do your best to introduce yourself to as many people as possible. And do it quickly. When they introduce themselves, say, hi Ashan, nice to meet you. And then practice a bit of small talk. Non-personal, non-threatening conversation. Easiest is weather, second best business. If there is nothing, look around and start talking about something. Remember this, you're not going to master these skills just because you listen to me. Like I said, if I'm working with a senior executive for a 1 hour presentation, I'll be working with them minimum 15 hours. Why? You need a lot of practice to do this. Now, don't worry that you don't have 15 hours. You know this bit. Go back and practice these things. And then incorporate the things that Chandi and Sampath shared as well. Work on your presentation, make it crisp and do that. Before I wind up, let me share with you one thing. Your reality is a manifestation of your beliefs. Your reality is a manifestation of your beliefs. That means your thoughts become your reality. Tamange situvili tamange adahas tamai tamange yatharthaya hatiyata jeevithayen labenne. Eka nisa nikan hari ogolla hitana nan mata meka hariyana ekak nae mata meka karanna bae mam mekata sudusu nae. You're right. You won't get it. Start your day, start your pitch, start anything that you do with positive intentions. Yahapat, shubhavadi situvillak ekak hemadeyen patan ganna because what you think in your head is what becomes a reality. Even before you go for the pitch, bring your team together or come yourself together for at least 30 seconds, close your eyes and in your eyes, see yourself going in front of that panel and delivering a fantastic presentation. And with that confidence, put a smile, and when you walk into that room, walk in front of that panel, be the most confident person in that audience. Because confidence wins anything. And your thoughts are what becomes your reality. Right? This is something that I learned from a person that I consider a guru, and I constantly learn from this person. He's an American speaker and a trainer called Anthony Robbins. And I had the blessing of seeing him twice live. In an audience, Tony Robbins, right? I have seen him twice live in the audience. I spend a lot of money to go and do that because he conducts only 4 live seminars every year of the category. I had to spend, but I did. And he taught something where when you wake up every morning before you do anything else, you're supposed to do 3 things. Number 1, You're supposed to close your eyes and remind yourself of three good things in your life that you are happy about. It could be your health. It could be your parents. It could be your job. Three things that you are happy about. Remind yourself, you go into this sense called attitude of gratitude. Immediately after that, think of three dreams that you want to achieve in your life. Could be that day, could be later in life, but think of three big dreams that you want to achieve. Win this competition, have your own startup, finish your degree, whatever it is. And then after you think of those dreams, think of three things that you will complete on that day. Can be simple small tasks, can be big tasks. Either way, three things that you need to do and finish on that day that is going to help you achieve those dreams. If you start your mornings with these three exercises, I guarantee you, your life will turn around. Because your reality is a manifestation of your intentions and your thoughts. Jeevithe apita labenne api hitana hoyena de. Ma vishwas karanne ne? Right. Your reality is the manifestation. Your thoughts, your words, and your deeds. Right? Your thoughts, words. Oh, right. Okay, sorry. The three things that you need to do. Early in the morning when you start, you think of three things that you are happy about. ඔයාගේ ජීවිතේ ඔයාට ලැබිලා තියෙන ටැග් නැත්තම් දායාද කියලා හිතන්නේ. අපි ඔක්කොටම අම්මා තාත්තා ඉන්නවනම් ඒක බ්ලෙසිං එකක්. තමන්ට ආදරය කරන ෆැමිලි එකක් ඉන්නවනම් ඒක බ්ලෙසිං එකක්. තමන්ට හොඳ හිතවත් යාළුවෝ මිත්‍රයෝ ඒ වගේ තමන්ගේ ජීවිතේ ඉන්න පුද්ගලයෝ ගැන හිතන්න පුළුවන්. තමන්ට තියෙන හැකියාවල් ගැන හිතන්න පුළුවන්. Your intelligence, that is why you're here today. You can thank your intelligence. And then you can thank the opportunities that you have. You can thank the good health that you enjoy. So think of three things positive. Then think of three dreams that you have. Three goals, three objectives that you want to achieve in life. It could be your startup, finishing your degree, winning this contest, whatever. Three things. And then immediately after that, think of three things that you need to complete on this day that will take you closer to those dreams. Three things. If that means finishing an assignment or putting in 4 hours of this or finishing a meeting or doing that, think of three things. If you start doing that, if I have time, I can teach you. Even before you go in for a meeting, you can do this visualization. If you start doing that, let me tell you this. In 2014, September, I was at the lowest point in my life. I was more than about 1.2 million rupees in debt. 60% of my monthly salary was paid purely as interest. 60%. I was just married and my wife was very unhappy with my financial situation. 2014. I met this trainer. I learned these things and I started doing these things every day. Fast forward, not even 4 years. I have been able to turn around my life. No debts. Not only that, twice a year I can take my family and go out for a holiday out of this country. And by this November, I'm going to say bye-bye to 15 years of corporate career. And I'm going to start my own business. And before I start my own business, I have already got three partners who have signed up to work with me. I've already got an order book before I start my business. I was patient. Consultation. HR consultation, right? I have already got my order book. And if I can credit all of that, I would credit it to that exercise that I do every morning. Three things that I'm happy about, three dreams that I want to achieve, three things that I'm going to do on that day that is going to get me closer. You may not see results today, tomorrow, but if you start it, I'm telling you, this is living proof. 4 years from now, I have been able to come to the best place in my life. I'm happy. And I'm sharing this with you. Let me end it by where I started. I know why I'm here. That is because if our country is to go forward, we need people like you to step up and take it forward. My contribution is I will come in and share my ideas. Your contribution is do your best. Believe in yourself and do your best. Tamanthula vishwasaya thiyaganna siyalu de karanna. Nitharama igena ganna alut deval honda deval kohomada deval karanne kiyala idiriyata e deval karagena yanna saha respect. Find your confidence and you will succeed because we need people like you to succeed if you are to have any hope for the future. I have no doubts you will achieve all of that. Right? So go ahead, do well. Thank you very much. And if you have any questions, I will quickly entertain that. But I think we are very much into time, so I don't want to disturb you anymore. Okay, everybody's ready. Now ask yourself, you didn't know why you were here. Did you get any value from this presentation? Not only mine, these three. Did you get any value?
Yes.
Did you get any value?
Yes.
Very good. Use it. Pass it on and then do something great with it. Thank you very much.